أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
إذا السماء انشقت
When the sky has split open
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا السماء انشقت When the heaven will be split asunder.
وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ
And has listened to its Lord and was obligated to do so.
وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ And it will obey the call of its Lord. And surely it has been ordained to do so. It has to listen and obey.
وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ
And when the earth has been extended.
وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ And when the earth will be stretched out.
وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا وَتَخَلَّتْ
And has cast out that within it and relinquished it.
وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا وَتَخَلَّتْ And it will cast outside all that is in it and will become empty.
وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ
And has listened to its Lord and was obligated to do so.
وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ And it will obey its Lord's call and surely it has been ordained to do so. Now this is again a picture of that day. Now is an أَرْضُ مُدَّتْ When this earth will be stretched. We know that this world is round. If it is stretched, what will happen? It will become elliptical first. And then maybe straight, absolutely plain. So whatever is in it will itself come out. So that is actually a logical result of this stretching of the world. This earth will be stretched. When the earth will be stretched and it will cast outside whatever is in it. These are the dead. These are the people who are buried in it. And this is, you know, everything which it has, it will throw it out.
يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه
O mankind, indeed you are laboring toward your Lord with great exertion and will meet it.
يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه O man, Surely you are ever laboring continuously and laboriously and you are sure to meet your Lord. This is a very important point. Man in this life has to undertake labor, hard work, struggle to earn livelihood. Whatever we have to do, everybody knows, to get the education. What you know, the youth coming from Pakistan, other countries, they are reading, but they are earning money, they are working. All these things. So this is lot of every human being, is to work and work and work and work. But then, suddenly one day, he will find himself standing before the Lord. Now bring forth your account. What did you do? If we compare ourselves to the animals, horses, they are drawing the whatsoever they are drawing, tangas, etc. But they are not going to be resurrected. Their tragedy ends with the death. Or, you know, the other beasts who carry load, they are working here. Working hard, no doubt. But no resurrection, no questioning. But the tragedy of man is twofold. Here, you have to suffer. Sorrows after sorrows. Griefs after griefs. Man has to have these shocks. Hard work plus shock. But then, over and above that, إِنَّكَ قَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ قَدْحَنْكْ فَبُلَاقِهِ But the real tragedy would be when you'll have to stand before your Lord.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ
Then as for he who is given his record in his right hand.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ So as for those who will be given his record in the right hand.
فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا
He will be judged with an easy account.
فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا Soon will his account be taken by an easy reckoning. What is حِسَابِ يَسِير? There is a hadith. The Prophet said that the account will be presented. That's all. Go. No detailed questioning. Many people from this ummah, the Prophet said 70,000 of my ummah, who are the mutawakkilun, who have total faith in Allah, they will have this entry. So for you hasabu hisaban yaseera. Just looking into it, and that's all. فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا
وَيَنْقَلِبُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا
And return to his people in happiness.
وَيَنْقَلِبُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا And he will return. After that peshi, you know, he was presented. But now he's coming back to his family and he's happy, joyfully, that I have been saved.
أَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ
But as for he who has given his record behind his back,
وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ And as for those who will be given the record behind his back, why? The angels will try to give him in the left hand, but they will keep their left hand back. They don't want to hold that. So they will be given from their backs.
فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا
He will cry out for destruction.
فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا So such a man will then call for death. Let death come to me. Would that death could come to me. Would that this be the end.
وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا
And enter to burn in a blaze.
وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا But he will have to enter a blazing fire.
إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا
Indeed, he had once been among his people in happiness.
إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا Verily, in the past life, he was with his family and he was enjoying the life joyfully. He had his joys and rejoices in that world. From haram and from all forbidden means he was earning and he was gathering all the comforts of life and the luxuries and everything. So, he has had his Whatever was his share, he already had it in that world. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا
إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَن لَّن يَحُورَ
Indeed, he had thought he would never return to Allah.
إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَن لَّن يَحُورَ He thought that he would never have to return to his Lord.
بَلَا إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا
But yes, indeed, his Lord was ever of him seeing.
بَلَا, why not? إِنَّ رَبَّهُ كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا Surely his Lord was ever beholding him, seeing him, what he is doing. And what for? To reward him.
فلا أقسم بالشفق
So I swear by the twilight glow
فلا أقسم بالشفق But nay, I swear by the afterglow of sunset You know the glow after sunset, the reddish light on the horizon This is shafaq.
وَاللَّيْلِ وَمَا وَسَقُ.
And by the night and what it envelops.
وَاللَّيْلِ وَمَا وَسَقُ. And by the night and what it envelops into it.
وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا اتَّسَقُ.
And by the moon when it becomes full.
وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا اتَّسَقُ. And by the moon when it grows full gradually.
لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقُ.
That you will surely embark upon state after state.
لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقُ. Surely, mankind, you shall certainly rise from stage to stage. These four ayat, as I have come to understand them, you may not find this opinion anywhere, so I am telling this my opinion, that these ayats, they denote the renaissance of Islam. Islam came with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The advent of Islam, the oaths we had in Surah Al-Muddassir, Kalla wal qamar, wal layl is adbar, was subh is asfar, innaha la ihdal kubar. Three oaths, and innaha la ihdal kubar, and this is the oath. Kalla wal qamar. You know the teachings of the former messengers of Allah, they were like the light of the moon, which is very light, no intense light. But layla is adbar. There was a 600 years long night during which there was no Nabi, no revelation coming, no messenger of Allah. But now, was subh is asfar. Now the sun of the messengerhood of Muhammad has arisen. Arisen is enlightened, lightened the whole this world. Inna ala ihdal kubar. Surely, surely, this advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is one of the biggest and mightiest things. Now the Prophet had said that after my death, four periods of time come before the end of this world. First, Khilafah ala minhaj al-Nubuwa, the pious caliphate, caliphate on the pattern of Nubuwa. The system which was established by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was retained absolutely in the same form, with no difference whatsoever. But then he said, ثُمَّ يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ ذَا شَاءَ يَرْفَعُ. When Allah will like, he will lift away this caliphate. ثُمَّ تَكُونُ مُلْكًا عَضًّا. Then there will be a period of cruel kingship, to which Allama Iqbal has denoted by the words Arab imperialism. The Umayyad period, the Abbasid period, it was not caliphate, kingship. And there were cruelties inflicted upon people. What happened at Karbala? What happened at Harra? For 3 days and nights, the Medina of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the city of Muhammad, was declared permissible for anything you do, for the army, whatever you do. This happened at the hands of the so-called Muslims. Then hundreds of Tabi'een were massacred, slain, killed by Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. And so on and so forth. But then the Prophet said, this period will also come to an end. Then there will be the third period. That will be kingship with slavery. ثُمَّ يَكُونُ مُلْكًا جَبْرِيًا. And which now I understand, I can't say what the companions understood when the Prophet divided this kingship into two periods. Kingship, which is cruel. Kingship with slavery. But now we can understand, it was the period of the colonial rule. At least formerly, although they were cruel people, but they were Muslims. Babar was a Muslim, Akbar was a Muslim, so to say. Jahangir was a Muslim, and so on and so forth. But then he became slaves to Queen Victoria, George VI. Edward the Eighth, and so on and so forth. So that was the third period. Then he said, ثُمَّ تَكُونُ خِلَافَةً عَلَى مِنْهَاجِ النَّبُوَةِ. Again there will be a period of خِلَافَةً عَلَى مِنْهَاجِ النَّبُوَةِ. This period is now not very far off. Also the doomsday is not very far off. إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. They see it as if it's very far off, and we see it close by. It's in front of us. So this renaissance of Islam, true Islam, not this Islam of ours. This is no Islam. We are individually Muslims. We believe in Allah. That's all. Where is Islam? There's a hadith, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a time will come. لا يبقى من الإسلام إلا اسمه ولا يبقى من القرآن إلا رسمه. Out of Islam, nothing will remain except its name. Out of Quran, nothing will remain except its script. This period is here. But true Islam, real Islam, practical Islam will be revived. There will be resurgence. There will be revival. There will be renaissance. And this time, this will cover the whole of the globe. I can't give you the detailed ahadith of the Prophet regarding this. But how this will happen, this is depicted here. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. Now actually what happened? What we have is, when the sun has gone down, there is some red light. Of Islam only we have this. Islam, sun of Islam has set. But only some light we find in the world of Islam. That is the afterglow of the sunset. وَاللَّيْلِ وَمَا وَسَقِ. And this very long night, you know, of the decadence of the Ummah, downfall of the Ummah, downtroddenness of the Ummah. But then, wal qamar is at tasaq, moon will rise, and gradually, it will become full. This process of revival of Islam and the renaissance of Islam is progressing stage by stage. There were some movements to begin with. They did some part. They contributed their bit. But then another movement came. The next generation, they are taking this standard a bit forward. The third generation, fourth generation. And during this 20th century, I can see at least in the Indian subcontinent, three generations have passed which are passing the standard and the, what should we say, the torch of Islam from generation to the other generation. But every generation is taking it upwards. لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا أَنْ طَبَقًا. The national movements, freedom movements, actually, they at least got for us freedom. When there is freedom, now it's easy for us to establish Islam. So there are movements, although we have not succeeded, except for, we may say, Iran, but that is a Shia country. In any other country, we have not succeeded. There is a success, but it has to be established. It's still, you know, very shaky, and all the kufr has gathered around it, and that is in Afghanistan. But Islam will be revived, and this is the prophecy of the Prophet, and gradually, this process is going step by step upwards. لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ.
فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ.
So what is the matter with them that they do not believe?
فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So what is to them? What's the matter with them? That they believe not.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ لَا يَسْجُدُونَ.
And when the Quran is recited to them, they do not prostrate to Allah.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ لَا يَسْجُدُونَ. And when the Quran is recited unto them, they don't fall and prostrate. This is the ayah of Sajda.
بَلِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يُكَذِّبُونَ.
But those who have disbelieved deny.
الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يُكَذِّبُونَ. Instead of believing in our recitation of our ayat, these people who are disbelieving, they belie.
وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُوعُونَ.
And Allah is most knowing of what they keep within themselves.
وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُوعُونَ. And Allah very well knows what they are gathering for themselves. Their deeds or the misdeeds, should be said, whatever they are gathering for the hereafter, Allah knows.
فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ.
So give them tidings of a painful punishment.
فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. So O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, give them the glad tidings of a painful chastisement.
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ.
Except for those who believe and do righteous deeds, for them is a reward uninterrupted.
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Except those who come to believe and do righteous deeds. لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. For them shall be a reward which will be unending, continuous, forever, forever.